And as police continue to look for the gunman in the University City shootout, an actor who grew up with the man who was killed Sunday is back in Philadelphia. He has a story of despair, but also of hope.
Excuse ain't nothing but excuse. My mom was on drugs, my pop was a dope dealer. Eh? But I made the wrong choice to go down and follow the gang in the street. That got me kidnapped.
He looking over his back. He can't trust half the people in his family. Running from the cops. That's the most stressful business. It's not cool, young boys. Selling drugs ain't cool at all. Everything that I sold, I lost. Including almost lost my life.
Because I was in a drug gang real heavy in the early 90s through the JBM era, and I was with a gang called the Zulu Nation, and it took me, I was kidnapped March 27th, 1995.
Only thing was I heard the last word, hurry up and kill this motherfucker. That's what I heard once they put a pillow over my head. Thank God the cleaning lady in the hotel room turned on the vacuum, and I'm standing here today to tell my story. That close way to get my hair blew off. Or better yet, maybe I did get killed in that room. And I'm just here on the dream to tell y'all my story.
For some people, this was just another drug shooting. Business as usual on the streets of Philadelphia. That is, of course, unless you live near here, go to school here, or maybe even knew one of the people shot. Someone like 27-year-old Shawn Banks, a former drug dealer turned professional television actor who knew the dead man, 22-year-old Anthony Davis, and only 2.5 months ago tried to get Davis to change his life.
And I was like, Anthony, you got it, you know what I mean? What's up? He called himself Tupac, you know, because he idolized the rapper Tupac or whatever, had a tattoo named Tupac. I said, why don't you just be yourself, you know?
Y'all gotta recognize, it's cool to be a nerd. You wanna be a gangster and get killed, then that's, you know, everybody in the neighborhood got their face on their t-shirt. Hey, rest in peace, boo-boo. Then he gone, then Mike dead. Then Mike dead, then Lil' Kevin dead. How many of y'all see that all day? Then how many people want their name up on the wall in the hood? Y'all want that? Come on, man. Rest in peace for what? Oh, candlelight vision with teddy bears. How many of y'all tired of seeing that? How many of y'all know somebody here got killed this close to y'all?
He says Davis, like so many other young African-American men, felt trapped in what he was doing.
You think you lost and you can never get out, so you just fall prone to, you know, selling drugs or trying to get the quick money.
And then Banks heard about the shooting Sunday near the University of Pennsylvania campus. That one man was killed, 3 others injured, in a wild shooting spree after the high school basketball championship at the Palestra.
I'm sitting home reading over my script, and I see his face pop up on the news. I hear about the shooting about the basketball game, but I never thought it was one of my friends, and it really hit it home.
Kids is killing kids. Y'all carrying guns bigger than y'all. But for what? How many of y'all want to die, man, right now? It sound good, look good, I ain't seen one hand raised.
And down the thing is, of course, it's a big business in the United States. You can see with the war going on over there, they're not going to stop making these guns. I had in the possession, I actually had grenades, silencers, and so forth coming from 3rd North, 5th and Susquehanna. And of course, we don't make them down there. But I was dealing with business people that was coming into the hood selling these guns. And what we try to portray to these kids, you got to make the right choice. Since that we can't stop them from making the guns, we got to give you the mindset not to pick these guns up and show the consequences what a bullet can do to you.
I believe in y'all. You got to believe in yourself. I was the same way when somebody told me I wouldn't be nothing. I wouldn't be able to do it once I start selling them drugs. When I start hanging around the right people, build myself around positive people, got my education, learned how to read, got into the entertainment business, and now I'm running my own company through the grace of God.
A final note, Banks now hopes to plans to spend much time trying to convince young African-American men that they can escape the trap of selling drugs and easy street money and do something positive with their lives. To that end, he says, he vows to work.
Yo, our future. How y'all gonna lead